In this shoemaking tutorial, I will teach you how to create this decorative element, perforation, and how to include this detail in any footwear type. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's start. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. At my YouTube channel, I asked you what tutorial you prefer the most, and you choose the tutorial about this decorative element, perforation. Usually, we use this decorative element in making men's shoes, like in this welted Oxford shoes that we made in one of my courses. But the secret is that this decorative element you can include, you can use everywhere in any footwear type. You can use this perforation in flat ballet shoes, pump shoes, T-strap shoes, I don't know, derby shoes, whatever. This perforation detail you can use in any footwear type and not only in making men's shoes. So in this tutorial I will show you how to create this interesting detail and how to include it in every footwear type. So let's start. This perforation we used on the Oxford shoes on each part of the upper. So it we have it on the vamp, on the toe cap, on the vamp, on the quarters, and on the back part. Now you can use this type of perforation in any place on your upper. And right now I will show you a simple example on the flat ballet shoes where I can use this interesting detail, this decorative element, perforation inside of the upper or flat ballet shoes in the toe cap. But actually you can do it everywhere. For example, you can use this perforation in making also, for example, flat ballet shoes, but not in the toe cap like I will show you in this tutorial. You can incorporate it in any part. You can use this detail and create many interesting elements inside of your pattern of the flat ballet shoes like this. And you can mix it with different colors or stay with one color. It can be like this. It can be also in the high heel pumps. Or T-strap, for example, let's make a T-strap. It can be with this detail like we have on the Oxford shoes in the shape of V and not V, W. So it doesn't must be on the men's shoes, it can be everywhere in every footwear type. We can use it here with the extra detail like we have on the Oxford shoes, the toe cap, or we can incorporate it inside of the upper without separating the entire upper on few details. It can be only with stitches and holes without any extra details. So I don't need to cut here and use this detail. I can use only stitches and holes and create visually this kind of pattern inside of the simple flat ballet shoes. Also, I can make it here, for example. You know, there is no limits here where you can use this detail in each part. Which place on the footwear you can use it. It can be on the center part, on the side part, on the back part, and it can be with any shape.
Okay, so is there this only two examples, simple examples, how you can use it, and you can find your style, your design of this perforation and inserting in any footwear type. So I choose to show you only simple flat ballet shoes, and the approach will be the same. I will show you how to do it when we will divide our pattern of flat ballet shoes on two parts. I will have the toe cap and I will have the main part. It's the same pattern that we made on in my course Fashionable Flat Ballet Shoes. It also divided on few parts. But you can do it, for example, if you already made flat ballet shoes and you have good pattern, correct pattern, you can use this basic pattern as it is, like this is basic pattern. And then inside of this basic pattern, you can use this perforation. So I decided to use this perforation, to make this perforation in the front part. So I divided my flat ballet shoes on two parts, with the toe cap like this, simple toe cap with a rounded shape, but it also can be with the W shape like this. Okay, or any other, it can be with this shape also. Like this, and finishing with this part, with this curve on the close to the bottom of our close to the edge of the pattern, or with simple rounded shape that can continue longer or be on the entire side of our shoe pattern. Okay, so you need to understand that this approach suitable for any footwear type, and you can use it in any place of your pattern. So I divided my basic flat ballet shoes on two parts and have this toe cap part. Now I need to create two different parts of the upper, the toe cap with the holes and the main part with the underline to sew these two parts together. So, for example, here I made this simple example with the perforation where I used different colors. You see two colors that suits each other, but you can use here same color like I have in this Oxford shoes, or use many different colors if you have more perforation on your shoes. Okay, so we start with the pattern making. To create a pattern, we need new piece of cardboard, and I use cardboard duplex 180 grams. You can use any other type of cardboard. It's important that it will be flexible and not too thick and not too thin. So before we will make the pattern, let's check how this perforation must be done. We make this perforation with two simple tools. It's actually one tool with two details. Puncher with different diameters. I will use here one puncher with diameter of 3 millimeters and puncher with diameter of 1.5 millimeters. You can use here another diameters, for example 4 millimeters, I think it's maximum. 4 millimeters is for the big hole, and 1 millimeter, for example, is the minimum that you can use here is for a small hole. But you can have few variations with these punchers, like mine, for example, I have 3 millimeter and 1.5 millimeter, so I can have 3 millimeter and 1 millimeter. So this is approximately the diameters of the punchers that you can use to create this perforation. So this perforation consists from one big hole, and between each big hole we have two small holes. Okay, in my Oxford shoe course, we marked this the marks for the perforation right away on the upper, on the leather of our upper. It's one way of making this perforation. There is another way where you will mark main holes, you'll mark main marks for the perforation inside of the pattern of the upper. Okay, and then all other marks, like mark for the seam, you'll mark only on the leather, and you will see how to do it in more advanced step of this tutorial. Okay, so why we can mark this seam on our upper, on our pattern, is because this seam is in the distance of 1 millimeter, and it's very difficult to mark this, to create this mark on the cardboard in the distance of 1 millimeter from the edge. We can ruin our pattern, cardboard pattern, and that's why this mark we will mark when we will move on and we will cut leather, and we will mark this line on leather. Okay, all other marks we will have on the pattern except marks for the holes, small holes, because same reason, to not ruin our upper, to not ruin our pattern, cardboard pattern, because if we will have too much holes on the pattern, with it will, you will ruin it very fast. Okay, so that's why in our pattern we will have only main marks to create this perforation, and this is one of the ways. Other way, as I explained to you before, mark all these marks directly on the upper, on the leather of the upper. Okay, so what we need to do, we will copy this line, the line where we will have perforation, on the other part of cardboard, on the part where we will create our pattern, and then we will also copy the outline of this edge. So let's copy this part, this line, the line of the elastic allowance, the edge of the pattern. Also, don't forget to mark the central line. It's very important. Central line you always need to have on each part of your pattern. So mark with 2 points of your knife central line. You can mark it also with awl. And then copy this line with the knife on the cardboard. So these 2 points of the central line, and this is the marks left from knife, and through these marks I'm drawing the line. Now before we will cut it out, let's make a central line. Through these 2 points, draw a central line and then score with a knife. Don't cut through the edge, don't cut through the edge, just score it. And then we will cut it out. Here we have mark of the inner side. Now we will create mark of the second seam that we have here. The second seam, this one, it will be on the distance of 1 centimeter from this edge. The first seam is on a distance of 1 millimeter, and we will mark it later on the leather, as I told you. This one we will mark on our pattern, and this seam is on a distance of 1 centimeter. To create this mark, you can work with compasses. Open it on the distance of 1 centimeter. And mark a line. This is line for the second seam. Now we also need to make marks for the holes. But yes, let's mark this line for the holes right now, and then we will create here opening cuts to have this mark to be able to transfer this line to mark this line on our leather upper. Okay, so the big holes will be in the middle of this area between this edge and the second seam. So if the total distance is 1 centimeter, in the middle will be 5 millimeters. So take your compasses and make this distance. I will use my instrument. I need 5 millimeters. So make this line parallel to the edge by placing your compasses like this and mark a line. So here will be along this line, middle line between edge and second seam will be holes, big holes. Now, these holes are in the distance of 1 centimeter between each other. It's not strict rule, it's just, I think, best distance for these big holes that we have on this perforation. It can be bigger if you want, but not smaller, because between these two big holes we'll have two small holes. So I think it's optimal distance between two big holes, 1 centimeter, but as I told you before, it can be a little bit bigger than 1 centimeter, like 1.2, for example, if you will use bigger holes here, for example, holes with the diameter of 4.5 millimeters, for example. Okay, so usually in this simple pattern, we can start these holes from the one edge and along this line until the other edge of our pattern. But I will show you how to start making these holes from the center line, because this approach you must use if you will have toe cap with this shape, with the shape of W, okay, or with the shape of V, where we have this kind of line, that center of this line is very important to have, and the hole must be exactly on the center, so we can't start it anywhere from the edge, one edge or other edge. It's very important to start make these holes from the center. It's suitable for this type of design, and that's why I will show you how to do it also on this simple toque, where it doesn't important if it's in the center or not, but if you will decide to change the shape, you will know how to do it. So we start to mark these holes from the central line. The first one will be in the center. Make the hole with the awl. Now all other holes we will mark along this line in the distance of 1 centimeter. You can open your compasses in this distance of 1 centimeter and mark the holes working with this mark, with these compasses like this. I will use my instrument 1 centimeter. The distance between each big hole. Now, to mark it through our leather, it's better to have small hole, and we will use here awl. So inside of each mark that you mark with the compasses, place a tip of the owl and make a hole. Now we need to have here mark that we will be able to draw on our upper of the leather upper. So let's make here a few cuts. It's possible here we can open in many different ways. So to not ruin our pattern, let's use this one. In the distance of 1 millimeter from each side of this line, you can do it by eyes. We will have this kind of mark. Like this. While it's 1 millimeter, approximately 1 millimeter from each side, because through this opening, through this cut, we will need to insert the tip of our pencil, silver pencil. It has the width of this pencil is approximately 1 millimeter, so we need to have enough space in this mark to insert through this opening, through this cut, this silver pen. Okay, otherwise we can use only this line in the distance of 1 millimeter from the original line, like this, 1 millimeter. Parallel, you can use it, you can make it by eyes in the distance of 1 millimeter, like this, and then we can cut like this and make this opening with zigzag shape. So when we will mark this line, because of the width of the pencil, the line will be exactly on the right place in the distance of 1 millimeter from this line. So it can be this opening, or as I started to explain you from the beginning of this one, I will show you also this type of the mark that we can use in pattern making, like this. So when I will mark here line, it will be exactly on this line, on the original line that we marked in the distance of 1 centimeter from the edge. Why we have here zigzag? Because we will know that zigzag is not our line. We don't use lines like this in pattern making to mark important lines. So we will understand that line that we need to mark is this line, the curved beautiful line, and not line like this with the zigzag shape. Okay, so then we need to mark the center with this mark in the shape of V, center of this pattern, of this part of our pattern. And now we have the first part where we will create perforation. Now this one. Because it's basic pattern, it doesn't have any seam allowance, so I will not copy the entire pattern, because it's important for you to know how to, what is the seam allowance that we need to add to this part to attach the first part of our upper. And because it's basic pattern, here when you will copy this pattern, you will need also to add, for example, if you have folding, you need to add 4 millimeters for the folding here. And then to this line, you need to add the underline. Usually for the perforation, the underline is approximately 9 millimeters. It's not approximately, it's 9 millimeters or 10 millimeters. Some shoemakers use even bigger underline, and that will be soon with the second stitch as well. But I personally don't like when I have too much layers on the upper. I don't have these thick pieces on the upper. So that's why minimum that I add for the underline to the detail where I have perforation is 9 millimeters. You see, this is the 9 millimeters, and it doesn't reach the second seam that we have here. Some shoemakers want that this part will be with the stitch, so it will be stitched also to the first part. So if you want, you can add for the underline not 9 millimeters, but 1.2 millimeters or 1 centimeter, okay? But minimum is 9 millimeter. I prefer to work with minimum because, as I told you, I don't like many thick layers inside of the upper. So what we need to do is that you will copy the entire pattern. Here you will need to add 4 millimeters, and then when you will copy this line, to this line you will add 9 millimeters or 1 centimeter or even 1.1 centimeter and 2 millimeters, as you wish. Okay, don't forget to mark central line always. For these points, we need to mark central line and then draw following the marks left from knife line, to which now we'll need to add 9 millimeters. Open compasses on the distance of 9 millimeters. And mark. I will use my instrument and I will add here 9 millimeters. Now I will not cut entire pattern because the tutorial is about perforating, but I explained you what you need to do is to cut entire pattern, add extra seams, seam allowance for folding if you have, or binding if you have. Here we have the inner side, so we need to mark it with this mark. And cut it out. Now we need to score line, and now we need to make here marks, because without these marks we will don't know how to attach the first part of our upper, the toe cap. So because of the same reason that silver pen has width, the tip of silver pen has width of 1 millimeter, so it's small detail, you know, but I prefer to work like this, so later I will not need to work harder to erase the marks of silver pen left on leather, you know. That's why it's better if mark left from silver pen will stay behind this edge, okay? And that's why we will mark, we will cut here marks from the distance of 1 millimeter from the original line, like this. It's almost 1 millimeter, it's even less than 1 millimeter. And before we will continue to make these marks, it's very important to have here hole over the center. And here also, we have this first hole, but let's make another one here, the small one that we will need to have to attach this part correctly to the second part. So we will attach it following these two central lines that will need to match each other like this, okay? You know, if it will be difficult for you to mark this line on a distance of approximately 1 millimeter, it's less than 1 millimeter, you know, it's, I don't know, it's in the width of this tip of the pencil. If it's difficult for you, you can mark exactly on the line, but if you will mark here, the marks of silver pen will be visible. Sometimes on some types of leather, like sweat, it's difficult to erase marks left from silver pen, and that's why I prefer always to mark lines, important lines, on the upper in the way where the silver pen will be covered with other part of the upper that we will be attached to the this one where I have these marks, okay? It's only way of work, you know. It if you want, if it will be difficult for you to mark these cuts in the distance of 1 millimeter by eyes, you can cut it exactly on the line that we have, like this here. For example, I will cut here exactly on the center, on the line that I have, okay? It's small difference, but for me it's important to have very clean and accurate upper parts. Okay, so you saw that one cut of this one line of this cut has same shape that the original line. If you will cut along this line, it will be exactly on the line. And second side has this zigzag shape, so when we will move on and we will transfer all these lines, we will know that line that we need to transfer is this curved beautiful line, okay? So now we have two parts of the upper here. Imagine I will have the entire pattern of the upper of flat body shoes, and then we will need to cut this and make perforation and sew it. There is a certain way how to do it, and in the next lesson I will explain you the exact steps of this work. Although it was a small detail, but like with all other small details in shoemaking, it consists from many different steps. So this tutorial was about pattern making. In the second part of this tutorial, I will teach you how to cut and how to sew. So this is a good time for you to ask me your questions about this process. So I will be ready with my answers in the next video. Now go ahead, ask your questions, and we will talk in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye!